Silent Yachts is one of the first companies that introduced solar yachts or luxury catamarans for private buyers. While they are marketed as solar yachts, you may guess that they still have a possibility to charge their batteries from a socket, because water resistance makes it almost impossible to generate enough energy to travel across seas and oceans with just several solar panels on the roof. But the thing is that when it comes to the Silent Yachts brand, they already sell their vessels to clients, while other companies offering solar yachts are mostly getting ready to launch their products. Silent Yachts have been on the market for quite a long time, and now we have some data to analyze. So there are currently three models of luxury yachts: the 60 series, 80 series and 120 Explorer series. The models are apparently named after their length in feet, so you can imagine the size of the catamarans. Every possible area is covered with solar panels. These are quite efficient panels that can work well in all kinds of weather, with even certain efficiency on cloudy days. I should say that I'm not that into yachting, but I'm really into modern technologies of electric, sustainable transportation. So I will not tell you about transatlantic trips or cruising in the Caribbean Sea from one island to another. I will mostly focus on the technical side of the question. And to do this, I will concentrate on the mid-range catamaran, the Silent Yachts 80 series. First, to make it clear, why can't we achieve practical sustainability in yachting? When it comes to roads, your average EV will need 15 to 20 kilowatts of energy to drive 100 miles, but when your EV is driven on the road, the battery will only need to slightly support the speed. The inertia will do the trick and you will just use a little energy for every mile driven. Acceleration will consume the most power, but water is not an asphalt road and yachts don't have wheels. Water creates resistance, and if you stop pushing your beautiful luxury yacht, it just stops at the same very moment. There is almost no inertia. The Silent Yachts 80 is submerged in water partially. The average draft is 1.5 meters or 5 feet, so the propellers need to work constantly to overcome that resistance. So to cruise 100 miles on a luxury catamaran, you will probably need about 3,000 kilowatts, and the consumption will grow insanely if you take the largest yacht available in Silent Yachts, the 120 Explorer. Let's put all the figures together to see the problem that Silent Yachts engineers will need to overcome in the future. First of all, the Silent Yachts 80 series is equipped with two 150 kilowatt electric motors. They will use about 240 to 300 kilowatts of energy an hour at cruising speed, depending on water conditions. The cruising speed is 6 to 8 knots, or slightly slower than 10 miles per hour. Now the battery pack is 207 kWh, and you can also buy the range extender pack that will give you additional 100 kWh of capacity. So basically you have the power on board to cruise about 10 miles or 8 nautical miles. Then you will need to stop and let solar panels charge the batteries, or find a place where you can charge the battery pack. The most interesting question is how much energy can you produce on a sunny day? And when it comes to the Silent Yachts 80, it can generate 160 kilowatt hours of energy a day. And this is, I should repeat, for a sunny day. So if things are good and you're lucky to have good weather, you may expect to travel additionally about 4 nautical miles or 5-6 miles a day using solar energy. With these figures, it's too early to market such solar yachts as fully sustainable autonomous solar vessels. But on the other hand, they may be marketed as sustainable recreational vessels that are silent, don't use directly fossil fuels to travel, and can be used in areas where nature should be as clean as 1000 years ago. Also, they are cool vessels for short trips, and you can surely use free solar energy for such purposes.